All right, welcome to the fifth video in the CCT Data Center course. In this video, we're going to be describing RAID, some of the core principles of RAID, and then we're going to go through some of the RAID types. So what is RAID? RAID is a cluster of disks to increase both the performance and the redundancy of disks. The drives have to be identical, meaning they have to be the same size, type, and speed. And the different types of RAID have different combinations of striping and mirroring. So what's striping? Striping is distributing the writes across multiple disks to increase speed. For example, if you're saving one file across two disks, that would double the speed of the write operation. Mirroring. Mirroring is pretty much what it sounds like. It's making multiple copies of data on different disks for redundancy. All right, so the first example of RAID that we have is RAID 0. It utilizes striping, but not mirroring. So it's striping across multiple disks. So this would add speed, but no redundancy. In our example here, I have a very rudimentary picture of two disks. So if you had one set of data, striping would have half of it on A and half of it on B. So the data would be split across the two disks. Again, no redundancy here, but it would double the speed of the write operation. RAID 1 is going to utilize mirroring, but not striping. So you're going to be mirroring it across multiple disks. This is going to add redundancy, but no performance boost. You can see in this example, I have another very basic picture of what it would look like with two disks. You're going to have the same data across both of the disks. Both would have a complete set of the same data. And again, this would be, obviously, you'd have redundancy. You'd be able to lose one of the disks, but you're not going to get any performance benefits from it. And then RAID 10 combines striping and mirroring across multiple disks. This is going to add speed and redundancy, but also it uses the most possible disks. So in this example, we have four disks. So you've got one copy of the data being striped across both A and B, and then you have that completely duplicated on the other side. So it essentially turns four disks into two disks, two completely redundant disks that it would double the speed of writing the data to one disk. And you're going to be fully redundant. All right, so before we can go into RAID 5 or 6, we have to discuss the concept of parity. Parity is where you use an extra drive that's designated as a parity drive, and it allows you to have fault tolerance. Another thing to note about the parity drive is that it doesn't matter how many disks you have, you would only need to have one parity drive. All right, so how does it work? In this example, we've got four disks total here. And obviously the algorithm is going to be a lot more complicated than I'm showing here. But with one parity drive, it kind of works like your basic algebra, where you have A plus B plus C equals P. And then if you were to lose B, for example, which is what happens in this example, the algorithm will know how to, like if the drive completely fails, what you would do is you would stick in a new B drive, and then the algorithm would basically restore that B drive. And it's able to kind of solve for it and know exactly what was on B by simply solving the equation. So if you follow what happens here, you know, we're subtracting B to this side, and then you know, you're able to basically isolate B, and you know, it can then define what B is. So if you think back to your algebra, you can only solve for one variable at a time like this, which means that you can also only lose one disk at a time. If you were to lose more than one disk before that B was fully restored, then you would have a data loss. I also know that if you were to lose one, the replication and the restoration process also puts additional stress on all the remaining drives. Which means that they are at an increased risk of losing another disk. Okay, so that takes us to RAID 5, which is using one parity drive at a time. This adds the benefits of striping across three drives and is fault tolerant up to one simultaneous drive failure, as we just discussed. All right, so in this example, you've got four disks. The data is being striped across A, B, and C, and then you have the one parity drive that would not add any storage capacity to the array. And so this would, again, triple the write speed, right? Because all of the data would be being striped across A, B, and C somewhere. All right, so RAID 6 is the response to the question, well, what if you want to have more fault tolerance than only losing one drive at a time? RAID 6 uses two parity drives.
So you're still striping, in this example, you're still striping across A, B, and C, so you're getting that triple write speed, but now you're fault tolerant up to 2 drive failures. Another thing to note is that the extra replication to that second parity drive does take a pretty significant performance hit relative to RAID 5. So I'm not sure exactly how much, but I do know that it's a pretty big performance hit. And this example has 5 disks. So what type of RAID is best? Well, the answer to a lot of these types of questions is depends. It depends on the specifics. It depends on the applications that you're going to have running on that memory. You can build everything out to maximum speed and maximum redundancy if you want to, but it's going to cost you. To my knowledge, RAID 1 and RAID 0 are seldom used in production because, you know, one has absolutely no redundancy and you almost never want that. And then the other obviously does not have any speed benefits. RAID 5 is known as the best bang for your buck for performance. Losing more than one disk at a time is extremely unlikely. RAID 10 is going to be the most expensive. It brings max redundancy and max striping, but it also requires the most disks. So it is, you know, obviously going to be more expensive. But I do know that it is, you know, most often used for critical applications like email and stuff that you just cannot lose data on. All right, well, that sums up this lesson on RAID. If you found it helpful, give the video a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.